en Conéctate con la Estrella.
Welcome, future generation leaders, to this third review lesson for 10th grade around the world. This is your teacher, Mrs. Ayala. Before to begin, let's review our last class. Do you remember why learning English is important? As you can see here, there are many reasons listed. For example, English is an international language of business, science, technology, diplomacy, aviation, etc. English is the language of the mass media. English is also the language of official institutions, commercial and industrial. All those are very strong reasons, but one important too is that English is the most widely spoken language on the world. I mean that many people in many countries understand or speak English as a second language. When it comes to traveling or visiting different countries, English solves the problem. What problem? If the people in that place do not speak the language, I mean Spanish, for example, as a result, having that basic knowledge in the language is very useful when you are traveling to different countries or trying to communicate or find your way around. So you will have more chances if you know English because of your ability to communicate. And it will be easier for you if you have a strong understanding of English. Your communication ability will be outstanding. So imagine that you got graduated and you're looking for an employment, or even if you're traveling, English as a language will be extremely beneficial and will certainly open up many doors for you guys. So keep practicing your English daily. This is my advice for you. Let's pay attention to the objective for this lesson around the world. Pay attention, please.
Welcome, students, to this review lesson around the world. In this lesson, you are going to examine some cultural aspects of places around the world and develop the four skills and understanding by practicing. Are you ready? Go ahead.
Those are very important objectives. There are some words and useful expressions that you will see during the lesson. For example, trek. Trek is to walk a long distance, usually hills, mountain, forest. We can say, okay, we spend the day trekking through the forest or on the mountains. Need is to have something or to want something very much. For example, babies need constant care. Drive. Drive is to move or travel on a land or in a motor vehicle. For example, she drives in her red sport car. Fly is to travel by aircraft. For example, we flew to Paris. Stay is not to move away or leave a place. And you can say, can you stay afterward to play tennis? Travel is to make a journey, usually a long distance. For example, I travel to Costa Rica by bus. Watch is look at something for a period of time, especially something that is changing or moving. For example, we watch television every evening. And the last one, visit, is to go to a place in order to look at or to look for a person in order to spend time with that person. You can say, when did you last visit the dentist? It's is a good question, guys. And some useful expressions for asking people things that they have done in the past. For example, we can say, where did you go for your vacation? Or how was your vacation? We can use expressions of surprise like, oh, that's amazing. So there are thousands of common verbs and expressions on the web, so you can find them and continue practicing, guys. Now, let's listen to the description of a place. I want you to guess, what place is it? Then you have to answer.
It is called the Land of the Rising Sun. It's an archipelago of more than 6,800 islands in the Pacific Ocean. The main islands are from north to south, Hokkaido, Honshu, Shikoku, Kyushu, which make up for 97% of its land. Its population is more than 126 million inhabitants. Climate, 4 distinct seasons. Food, apart from rice, staples include noodles. It has also many dishes, such as fish products in broth called oden, or beef in sukiyaki and nikujaga. Mount Fuji is one of the attractions. Baseball is the undisputed top sport there. It is located west of the Republic Ocean in the northern hemisphere.
Now that you listen carefully, where is it located? That's right, in the west of the Pacific Ocean. What is the food that is common in that place? Great! Rice, noodles, seafood, and beef. Great. The sport. Baseball. Mention one touristic attraction. Yes, the Mount Fuji. Very good. How many people live there? Let's see. Oh, very good. 126 million inhabitants. That's a huge place. And finally, tell me the name of that place. Yes, Japan. Very good. Very good. Excellent job. Now, let's pay attention to my journey to different places around the world. First, I went to South Africa. Pay attention.
Hey guys, I drove to the Kruger Park in South Africa to see the wildlife. I saw lions, giraffes, elephants, turtles, zebras, deers, a lot of impalas, and even saw leopards walking around. So guys, come with me and continue exploring the world.
Gorgeous, guys. Now, I went to Cusco, Peru, specifically the Machu Picchu. Pay attention.
I came to Peru. I visited Cusco, the ancient capital of the Incas Empire in the Andes Mountains. From there, I trekked to the ruins of the old Inca city of Machu Picchu. Machu Picchu is called as Aguas Calientes. It took me 4 days going through the main access route to Machu Picchu. The most significant stone is the Intihuatana, or solar calendar, which allowed the Incas to know precisely the seasons and the weather throughout the year. I enjoyed this trip. Let's continue, guys.
Yeah, I also visited Cappadocia in Turkey. Pay attention.
I visited Cappadocia in Turkey. I saw the houses cut into the rocks and the ancient underground cities. Cappadocia's landscape was formed by volcanic erosion. Thick ash solidified into a soft rock called tuff. Another time, the tuff rocks erode with wind and water, creating the iconic fairy chimneys we see today. I flew in a gas balloon and the view from the balloon was awesome. So guys, come with me. Let's continue learning.
And finally, but not less important, I went to a beautiful place in our country. Pay attention.
Hi guys, I'm here. I came to the San Blas Islands of Panama. It's an archipelago comprising approximately 365 islands and caves, of which around 49 are inhabited. They lie off the north coast of the isthmus, east of the Panama Canal, a part of the comarca Gunayala along the Caribbean coast of Panama, is home to the Gunas people. I have enjoyed all these trips and I invite you to practice with me. Let's see if you pay attention to all the information that I presented.
Wonderful place, don't you think so? So there are a lot of wonderful places that we need to explore in our country. Now, let's practice. Let's answer true or false. Very simple. According to the video, Mrs. Ayala's trek to Machu Picchu for 4 hours? Yes, true. She flew in a balloon to see the view in Beijing, China? False. She saw a lot of animals in South Africa? True. She visited San Blas Island? True. And the last one, she went to Cusco? True. So this is a very simple true or false. Practice. As you can see here, there are some ED pronunciations of the verb in past. So let's review the pronunciation of the verb in past tense but in regular form. So we have a quick review here. The end of the ED verb in past. He lived in China. He played the guitar. He worked in Turkey. She watched the bird. T sound. They visited Mexico. They needed visa. Id sound. Let's see what happened here. So these changing sounds result from whether or not the vocal cords vibrate to create that sound right before the ending. For example, when we say kissed, 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 because there is no vibration in the vocal cord, kissed. It's voiceless when we say the consonant. It is implied efficient for your vocal cord to continue not vibrating or pronounce the ED at the end as a voiceless kissed. Similarly, when you say called or buzzed, 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 because the vocal cord vibrates your voice, when we pronounce the Z consonant. So the ending continue to vibrate and the sound sounds like a d, d, d at the end, buzzed. And when there is a T or D ending before the ED ending, the ED ending will be pronounced like it, id, id. For example, wanted, wanted, wanted. Let's repeat with me. Kissed, kissed, helped, helped, walked, walked, called, called, buzzed, buzzed, happened, happened, wanted, wanted, needed, needed, included, included. Excellent, guys. Let's continue practicing. So now we have some grammar structure for simple past tense. Remember, simple past indicates an action which is completely completed as a definite time in the past. Remember this. So in this example, we have yes, no questions. They require short answers, followed by yes, no. We also called these type of questions closed questions. For example, the structure we use. The auxiliary do in past, that is did, plus the subject, plus the main verb. So the question, did she, or did he, or did you, or did they visit the Eiffel Tower? And the answer in affirmative, we have yes, plus subject, plus did. Yes, she did. Or in negative, no, plus subject, plus did not, or didn't. No, she didn't. This is very simple. Just you need to practice the structure. What about, let's see this practice. Look at the pictures. Look at the picture and answer. We are talking about Samuel. Did Samuel travel by bus? Which is the answer? No, he didn't. Did he stay with friends? Look at the picture. Yes, he did. Did he buy grapes? No, he didn't. So I want you to build your own yes, no questions. Look at this picture and try to build your own yes, no question. Remember, follow the structure. And what about if you want to get more information? We need to use open questions, because with those open questions, we can receive infinite number of answers. So how do we structure those open questions? Using the WH question words. Which one? We have where, what, when, why, who, at the beginning of your question. And then we have to add the do or did, and then the subject. How she, you, or they get there? Why did she move to New Orleans? Or where did you live 10 years ago? So you can receive more information with these open questions. Remember the structure. The structure is the similar like the one that we saw before. We just add the W question at the beginning, plus did, plus subject, and plus the main verb. Remember. Now, let's listen to a conversation, and I want you to answer the questions. Pay attention.
How was your vacation to Mexico?
It was very interesting. I learned a lot. In the center of Mexico City, we visited the ruins of a temple. Did you know that Mexico City was the capital of the Aztec Empire in the 15th century and had a population over 200,000 people?
Wow, that's amazing.
Then we went to a place outside Mexico City to see the ancient pyramids.
Did you climb up?
Only the Pyramid of the Sun. It was too hot.
What else did you do?
We went snorkeling in Cozumel. I really enjoyed it.
And did you enjoy the food?
Oh yes, I love spicy food, but in Mexico it was too hot, even for me. There even the little kids eat chilies.
Okay guys, now that you could listen to this nice conversation, let's try to answer. What historical site did Brian visit in the center of Mexico? Tell me. Robertito. Yeah, the ruins of a temple. Very good. Number two, why did he go and visit the place outside Mexico City? Martita? That's right. To see the ancient pyramid. Good. Number three, what did he do in Cozumel? Samantha? Yes, snorkeling. That's good. And number four, what did Ryan think of the food? Samuel, tell me. Yes, he loved the spicy food, but the food from there was too hot. That's right. Thank you. Very good. Excellent. It's time to unscramble the sentences to build these questions. We have a yes-no question and an open question, W question. So first, the auxiliary past, did. Then what else? The pronoun or subject. And then the verb, take. Very good. Did you take what? A taxi? When? Yesterday. And the question mark? Don't forget the question mark. Very good. This is a yes-no question. The answer must be yes, I did, or no, I didn't. Remember, very short answers. And now the second one. We have W question here. When? Then we have auxiliary in past, did, and then we have a subject, you. Very good. And then the main verb, fly. And then to India. Remember the question mark, guys. When did you fly to India? This is an open question, remember. When did you fly to India? I flew to India 10 years ago. So you can receive more information than just a yes-no question. I flew to India when I was a child. So the opportunity to answer are widely. So let's continue. Very good job. Excellent. So I hope you could learn something today. And remember, you need to continue practicing. That's why in our assignment, you have to do something very interesting. Record a podcast. Do you know how to do it? What I'm gonna do is to describe a place that you have visited. So you have to describe things that you did during your trip. This is what you're gonna talk about. First, the first tip that you need in order to develop your podcast is to prepare a plan, like an outline. You have to write like the script, the draft about what you're going to say, what you're going to record, and practice. Practice before recording, please. Also, after you have practiced, you have everything ready, I want you to download a software from App Store, as I mentioned. It is called Spreaker. Spreaker. You can use it on your cell phone or you can use it online. So this is what you have to do. And in this quote, you can scan this quote. Remember that I always ask you to download a QR code reader so you can find a tutorial that is going to help you on how to develop this activity, the step by step. So how can you record a podcast? In your cell phone or in your computer. So here you have the link. Let's pay attention to the presentation of this step by step. Pay attention.
Hello students, today I'm going to show you how to record a podcast using your cell phone, downloading the app from App Store, and also from your computer. You have to write Spreaker Studio. The icon is color red. You just download it on your cell phone and you can start. Once you are here, you can record your podcast immediately, and then you just click on recording. I'm recording right now. Once you have finished, you click on stop. Hey, you finished recording. Then you click on share or save. You share. You have to write a title and in what section you're going to record the podcast. Okay, you can write a description and also add an image from your cell phone. Then you click on upload down. You can Okay, as you can see, the podcast. What you see here is the same that you will see on your laptop. If you access with the same username and the same password, you will find this on your computer too. As you can see, you have the option for sharing, and that's it. It's very simple. And it is something that we can use to share our lessons with our students.
That's interesting. So you can add sound effects too. As you could see, it's very simple how to record a podcast using your cell phone today. This is the quote, join us guys. And also, be aware, remember guys, you have to take care of yourself, you have to wash your hands, constantly wear your face mask, and use hand sanitizers. That's very, very important. I want to say thank you to our academic coordinator, Daira Frampton, also all the sponsors that made this lesson possible for you during these difficult times. So much. So don't miss our next lesson. Remember, knowing and trusting in your own abilities will help you on your path to success. So goodbye guys, see you next time with more lessons for 10th grade. Take care of you, goodbye.